Welcome back to our series on being a new streamer, figuring out your content, where you want to take it, what you want to do with it. Today we're talking about a question I feel like not a lot of people are asking themselves, especially, I think it's especially important starting out, is should I stream? And if that question makes you uncomfortable, then this video is definitely for you. If you just want to stream for leisure, kind of a pastime, you know, this video still might help you enjoy it more. If the answer to should I stream is no, then I'm not sure how you got here, but I do appreciate your view on the video. And if the answer to should I stream is yes, then let's tackle it this way. Who, what, when, where, why, and how? First off is who. The biggest and most existential question of all. You might say, who? Me? Duh. I'm gonna stream. But who are you? How well do you know yourself? What are your strengths? And I don't mean what games you're good at. Knowing and learning who you are is a lifelong endeavor. And I'm not saying you need all the answers to start streaming, but the better you know yourself, the more you'll enjoy the journey. Don't feel like you know yourself that well? Use streaming as a way to explore what you're interested in. The more you know and learn about yourself, your values, your likes, your dislikes, the better you'll be prepared to answer what. What are you going to stream? Seems like the obvious question. And while it's a question you'll have to answer, there's a more important what. What do you bring to the table? Like I said, the more you know about yourself, the easier this question is to answer. The hardest part is the amount of honesty and self-awareness it takes to answer truthfully. What can you do for people? What are your strengths that will provide value for your viewers? Your content and anyone that watches it will be better off if you're putting a level of passion, knowledge, or experience behind it. That can, of course, be a type of game you're skilled at or passionate about, but even if your focus will be streaming games, considering other subjects or activities to break up your content will help keep things fresh for you and everyone watching. If you're having trouble deciding what your strengths might be, ask the people closest to you. This can be a little scary, but asking someone you're close to for complete honesty about your strengths, and if you're brave, your weaknesses, can give you insight you wouldn't have otherwise. Once you have some ideas of what you can best bring to the table, you can decide on when. What time you stream is important, and you can put a lot of time into researching what might work best for you. But more important starting out is what time frames work for you. Even more importantly, how much time can you devote to your stream and the effort it'll take to help it grow. This doesn't mean streaming 7 days a week, but the amount of time you have each week to put content out to social media and YouTube on top of streaming. Like understanding yourself to best understand what you can bring to the table, being honest about the amount of time you have to put into streaming can really help manage your expectations for growth and realistically focus your energy where it will count the most. Combined, these can help you stay the course while preventing burnout. But now, an easy one. Where? It's not all tough questions. As of the time of this video, you really only have three streaming options: Twitch, YouTube, or Facebook Gaming. I haven't heard many great arguments for Facebook Gaming, so I would suggest choosing between Twitch and YouTube. Twitch obviously has a huge live streaming pedigree, especially when it comes to video games, but discoverability options are still very limited. YouTube can do better on discoverability, but the live streaming portion isn't quite as fleshed out. My biggest suggestion, besides doing a little research and deciding what's best for you, is to diversify. Even if you're time limited, and who isn't, picking a few platforms to, you know, focus your efforts on and put your energy into keeps you from being limited to growing in one space, and more likely than not is going to help you grow in the other spaces, especially when it comes to growing on Twitch. None of these big services are going anywhere. Having multiple outlets can protect you from surprises like a copyright strikes or other interruptions down the line. Speaking of things that can get in the way, it's important to know why. While this is closely linked to what and what you bring to the table, the why is a more personal motivation for streaming and creating content. Do you like making people laugh? Do you want to teach something? Do you want to build a community around a game or a cause that you love or care about? This is a question only you can answer, but having a clear motivation can build a solid backbone for your content. And just as important, it gives you something to look toward, whether you need new ideas or just a reminder of what you're working at. And finally, how? The how is really for another video. Oh wait, we already detailed how to get started streaming for under $100. But as you decide on what you'll be creating, you might find that your technology needs change as you do. At the end of all of this, that's what it really comes down to. You. What you need to create to the best of your abilities to bring the most you can to anyone that may watch. I hope this video has helped you outline a game plan or maybe rethink the one that you had. Feel free to share any of your own sticking points in the comments below or DM us on Twitter or Instagram to have your questions answered in an upcoming video about being your best self while live or creating your content. Be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out. Until then, happy creating. You know yourself that well? Use streaming as a way to explore what you're interested in. Like understanding yourself to best under... Feel free to share...